Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys about encapsulation in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Let's talk about encapsulation. This is the concept of attributes of a class being hidden or private. They can be accessed only through special methods called getters and setters. And you really should make attributes private if you don't have a reason to make them public or protected. In this tutorial series, I don't, just for learning purposes. I want to make things as less complicated as possible, so I tend to not use encapsulation. But for your own programs, you probably should, just to add a layer of security. So I have an additional class for this example called car. Let's make some private variables. So let's say we would like a make, a model, and a year. So I want to make these private so that only this class can access them. So private string make, private string model, and private int year. Let's also set up the constructor of the class while we're here. So the parameters are make, model, and year. String make, string model, and int year. And when we construct a car, we'll just say this.make equals make, this.model equals model, and this.year equals year. Now let's attempt to construct a car object. So car, car equals new car. What kinds of arguments do we want to pass in? We need a make, a model, and a year. So for this car, let's say that this is a Chevrolet. For the next argument, maybe a Camaro and a year, 2021 is good. So this will work just fine. What would happen if we attempt to access one of these private members, like the make, the model, and a year? Let's find out. So system.out.println, I'm going to attempt to print the car's make. And let's see what happens. Well, there's a problem. The field car.make is not visible. That's because this is private. All of these variables are private, so they are hidden. Only this class has access to these members, make, model, and year. So what can we do to retrieve the value of one of these variables? We can use a getter method. So that is a special method found within the class that contains these private members that will send the make, the model, or the year, whatever variable you're working with, to whatever class is calling that method. So we're going to create a getter method for each of our variables that are private, make, model, and year. So let's begin with make. So this is going to be a separate method. It's going to be public. The return type is a string, and we will call this get, then the name of the variable, make. And all we're doing is returning the make, and that's it. Let's repeat the process for model and year. So public string get model, return whatever our model is. And lastly, this is returning an integer, and this is get year, return year. And in order to access one of these attributes, one of these variables, we need to use the appropriate getter method. So instead of accessing this attribute directly, we're going to use one of these methods. Get, and we have make, model, and year. So let's get the make of this car. And it's going to return Chevrolet. So it's as if we're asking this class nicely, can we pretty please get the make, the model, or the year of your car? So that's one way in which you can access a private attribute. You use a getter method, and then you can call that method from anywhere, basically, since we made this public. And if you need to retrieve the other private variables of this class, you just use the appropriate get method. So let's say we want the model, so car.getModel, and the year, car.getYear. So this will retrieve all of the private variables of our car object, Chevrolet Camaro, the year is 2021. So now how can we change the private attributes of an object? Well, we can use what's called a setter method this time. Let's attempt to change the year of this car. Car.year, and we'll change this from 2021 to 2022. Well, the issue that occurs is that the field card.year is not visible since we set this to private. So we would need to create a method called a setter to set the year of this card, the make, the model, and the year. It's kind of like what we did with our getter methods, but these are called setters. So let's create a setter method for the make, the model, and the year so that we can call this method to change one of these values. So this is public. The return type is void. We're not returning anything. And we'll call this set and then the name of each variable that you're working with. So let's create a setter for the make. And we do need one parameter, whatever our make is. So if we call the set make method, we have to pass in a new argument. So string make. This dot make equals make. And actually, since we're setting the make here within a setter method, we no longer need this line. What we could do is call the setMake method within the constructor now. So this.setMake, and we have to pass in our make. And let's repeat the steps for model and year. SetModel, this will take a string model. This.model equals model. And we no longer need to set that within the constructor. We'll just call this.setModel and pass in our model. And lastly, we have the year. Public void set year. This has one integer parameter, int year. This.year equals year. And we can just call that method this.setYear and pass in our year. And now if we need to change one of these values, we can use the setter method, car.setYear, and we'll pass in a year, like 2022. And then let's display all of these values using our getter methods. And now our car is a 2022 Chevrolet Camaro. Well, that's the basics of encapsulation. All we're really doing is making the attributes of our class private, so that they cannot be directly accessed from elsewhere within our program. If you need to retrieve one of these values, you can use a getter method. If you need to change or set one of these values, you can use a setter method so that you can indirectly either get or set these values, and other classes do not have direct access to these values. So if you'd like a copy of all this code, I will post everything in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of encapsulation in Java.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.